I think it's ludicrous to suggest that the length of school, the length of the skirt of a student is going to affect a teacher's performance or behaviour or how they act. Teachers are professional members of a body. It's up to them to act in an ethical way.
But it may affect pupils' performance, both the girls who are sitting worrying about the length of their skirt as opposed to their lesson, and their boys who they may be in the class with.
I think taking the drastic decision to ban school skirts is the wrong approach. Most schools, as we know, have a student body. I think the best way to do this is to go through a more of a coaching approach. So it's to get the students to tell the teachers and the headmistress what they think the best thing to do is.
But I think where Dr. Blinko is radical in this, where this is different, Dr. Blinko, is that you have decided, do you know what? I'm not here for these distractions. I am here to teach these children to improve this school. And that's the approach you're coming from, isn't it?
Exactly. My job is to make sure that the students get the very best education. And by having to spend hours making sure that students wear skirts of the right length or stop them hitching them up, it sets the wrong learning environment. Because if we're challenging students, sort your skirt out, when they go into a lesson, we're not creating that right learning environment, which is a positive thing, so we can give the very best education to the students in the school. That's what it is. I just want to remove that as a distraction for any learning that's going to go on within the classroom.
See, I'm already thinking, when I was at school, we had a very strict policy in my school, and your skirt had to be no more than 1 inch above your knee.
Yes.
And it was very much enforced in school. I would never have hitched my skirt up in school because the consequences were quite severe.
Yes.
So you would be put in a week-long detention. So it was made very clear that if you did that, the punishment was severe. So nobody did it. But
yes,
we also did it outside school.
Yes.
So my question to you is, maybe your punishment is not what you might be not punishing severely enough to stop this happening. Surely you shouldn't have to be telling them every single day in school.
I think we've tried. I've tried for 2 years. In every classroom, we've got pictures up which says what's acceptable and
so
what isn't acceptable.
This is your
That's
picture,
right.
Yeah.
Yes. That is up. And I've been asking them for 2 years to say, get this sorted, get this right. We do detentions, we do contact home, we
Why
do...
Why is it not working, then?
Well, they don't listen.
No, they don't listen. Yeah. And even if they do come in with the right length of skirt at 9 o'clock, by 10 o'clock, when they're going into the next lesson, they've rolled it up, they've hitched it up, etc.
But and isn't it just up to the teacher then in that class to say, right, out
Darling,
of my classroom
look,
until you got
what,
the skirt at the right length?
What the problem is, it doesn't matter if 100 are disobeying or one.
Yeah.
The very fact that one disobeys, yeah, it's eating up her time
my
and teacher's time.
I don't want staff wasting their time in sorting out skirts.
Where
is it a waste of time?
I mean, so a couple of years ago, the clip-on ties were introduced at the school.
Brilliant
yes.
idea.
Yeah.
Brilliant idea.
And it worked.
But
because we didn't
want... Where did you draw the line, though?
Were you unruly at school?
Was I unruly
yeah.
at school? I'd test the boundaries, as every student would, wouldn't you? So if a rule is introduced like this, or a rule is introduced about the clip-on ties, the students will push the boundaries and they'll test the...
But they don't now. They don't. Well, I don't have any arguments about top buttons or ties because actually that's what they do. That's the standard, that's what I expect. And you eliminate, and what I want to do is exactly the same, eliminate the waste of time that teachers are spending, and not just teachers, all support staff, in trying to get them just to be to compliant so we can actually focus on what we're there to do, which is to give a high quality
education.
We want
girls to feel comfortable in what they're wearing as well. So if we're introducing this blanket ban on skirts, girls come in all shapes and sizes. Some of them are not going to feel comfortable wearing trousers.
Ah, fair point.
Yeah, and actually,
but they all wear
next,
trousers.
You know, I can see your next problem coming. I go, right, I've got to wear black trousers to school. If I was at that age, I'd be straight into skinny jeans.
Exactly.
What's black? There's grey black.
Have you looked at the policy on the website?
No,
it clearly says no jeans, no skinny trousers, no cotton trousers, no leggings. We
but
know what we want.
Don't you think they're going to bulk against
Do you know what
well,
amazes
they haven't
me?
Got
Do you know what
males?
Amazes me? I am fascinated with all this.